Welcome to my video about how to test relative click latency with two gaming mice. What you'll need is, at first, two-sided alligator clips, which are alligators on both sides, a baseline, for which I'm using a Gamdias Apollo. It's handy if the click latency is known, so you can do the calculations and put it in the spreadsheet and compare more properly. And if the baseline doesn't add extra latency when lifted. So it doesn't matter if it's tracking or not, it will have the same click latency, because otherwise it can be a bit annoying to have it like tracking all the time. Second is your second gaming mouse, which in this case I already know latency of, but just for the test. So to get started, you will also need a.exe or key response PK from Bloody. I prefer a.exe because I can just dump the results in a log file and just work with those. I'll get into that how to use the program later. First, for the setup, you take your game mouse A, and you either take the middle pin from the right click or the middle pin from the left click, which in this case I'll do the right click. Just grab it. Then you take your second PCB, then you attach it to the left click of the second gaming mouse at the middle pin, which can sometimes be a bit tricky. Okay, I switched them around because it wasn't being cooperative. It's fine.
Through the magic of video editing, I'm now on my desktop in the folder where I have a.exe stored. So what I attempt to do is open the program itself, take the baseline mouse, and if you click on the left click, because of how it's wired, it will actuate both the left click of one mouse to the right click of the other one, and the difference is printed. So if you click once, you'll get minus 4.3 ms. So that means that on this click event, the baseline is 4.3 ms faster than the gaming mouse you're testing. If you do it a couple of times, you'll see that there's some variance, and this variance can vary up to 10 ms depending on the mouse itself. Do this a couple of times, and you'll start seeing values. Now, to properly work with this data, what you can do is you go in here, you type cmd a.exe arrow to the right, and then you give it a name. So in this case, it's called trust.log because it's a trust gaming mouse. Now everything that's clicked will be recorded in that log file. So I'll click, I don't know, a couple of times. I tend to click normally because sometimes spam clicking can cause extra delay. In some cases, I've seen it happen. Just click a couple of times. I won't do it as much because it'll be quite a long video. Once you're done, you'll have the values in a log file like this. So once you have your log file, I prefer to go into Notepad++ and then go Control F and replace all periods with commas, because I'm European and I have to use commas for numbers and the program prints them in periods. I can probably change it in the Google environment, but I can't be bothered. Then I take all these values, Control A, Control C, go into a spreadsheet like this, paste them in, like so. It's in Dutch because that's the language I use. But then I go into functions, average, press enter. So on average, it's 4.17, so 4.2 ms slower than baseline, the mouse I'm testing. Because if it's negative, then the left click's faster. If it's positive, the left click's slower. So it's 4.2 ms faster. And I know my baseline is 1.4 ms slower than the Ikari. So the mouse I'm testing is 5.6 ms slower than the Ikari, which is the same as last time I tested it, so probably means that the result is correct. There are some exceptions, mainly optical clicks. You can test some, but I'll probably do a separate video on how to do that. There's the XM1, which just doesn't work because they use a different way of debouncing. And then any mouse that uses an MCU made by a company called eVision or EEVision. They're not very common, but they don't print anything. They do something differently with the switches, so you don't get any values if you test it like this, and I don't know why, and I haven't figured out how to fix that either. So I'll probably make a part 2, where I'll just show how to do LKV1s, which are the first generation light strike optical switches, and then probably also talk about how you probably could do the LKV2, which are like the Razer opticals and the ones Cooler Master is using right now, and how to test those, because it's possible, but it's a bit harder. It requires soldering and stuff like that. That's the video on how I prefer to test relative click latency instead of bump testing. And it's still fairly easy as long as you have the right equipment and the know-how.